As a child, Julia was often asked where her mother was. And the girl would tell them that her mother sailed on a research vessel in distant seas, conquered the highest mountain peaks, went on archaeological expeditions. And the neighborhood kids and classmates at school were jealous and amazed at what a cool mom Julia had. The truth was very far from those childhood fictions. Her mother had simply left her for her rich lover. When Julia was 4 years old and her father was downsized at work, times were hard in their family. And her mother loved the carefree life and soon found a man who could provide it for her. The girl stayed with her father and they lived in real poverty. For many years she was glad that they didn't even have a camera and didn't have any pictures from that horrible time. Julia's father didn't give up, but he hardly had time to be with his daughter. The man had to earn money wherever he could. He worked as a longshoreman, a construction worker on construction sites, did repair work for people. Sometimes he asked an elderly lonely neighbor to babysit his daughter in exchange for his help. And sometimes he would simply turn on the TV to Julia, lock her in the house alone, and go to work. The girl was very afraid to be alone and cried every time her father left. But her father did not respond to her tears. He was forced to do so because they needed something to live on. At that time, the girl did not understand why her father left her so often and where her mother had disappeared to. Those were very hard times. And yet Julia and her father not only survived, but also got back on their feet. When the girl was 7 years old, her father found a steady job and he was well paid. Then he got a friend who had capital, and they opened their own business. Thanks to her father's perseverance and luck, the family forgot about poverty. The man was successful in the end, but Julia saw that he had changed a lot. He was already tough enough by nature. And when he got rich, he became rude and cynical and believed that everything in this world could be bought for money. Julia noticed that her father no longer respected people. When she went to his office, she saw him speaking rudely to his staff and believing that it was normal, since he paid them well. Julia felt bitter and ashamed of her father on such occasions, but she still loved him very much. Julia graduated from school and began studying at the university. She wanted to be independent of her father and his money, and even at university she preferred not to stand out among her fellow students. Only after a while it became known anyway, and many guys started courting the rich girl. Her father said that they were trying for money. The girl was offended to hear such things, but she realized that in most cases her father was not wrong. Time passed, and Julia graduated from university and went to work at her father's company. And then she met Nathan. He was a simple guy, but he bribed everybody with his sincerity and optimism. He was an electrician and they met when he was repairing sockets in her apartment. The father bought it for Julia upon her maturity and it was an ordinary apartment without much extravagance. Nathan and Julia dated for about a year before she introduced him to her father. The father, of course, was not thrilled with his daughter's choice. But still, when he got to know Nathan better, he was even kind of glad, though he did not show it. Julia's calm and measured life was interrupted by a phone call from an unknown number. An unfamiliar woman's voice greeted Julia. When she asked who it was, she heard in response that it was her mother. Out of surprise, Julia did not know what to say. And her mother, whom she had not seen for over 20 years, said she wanted to meet her daughter. Julia thought for a while and agreed. She wanted to look into the eyes of the woman who had traded her child for a lover, and tell her about her difficult childhood and how hard it was to live without her mother. The meeting was set at a restaurant. Julia walked into the hall and immediately recognized her. The beautiful and elegant woman rushed towards her and wanted to hug Julia, but the girl did not reciprocate. When her mother chose the most expensive dishes from the menu, it became clear that she was used to luxury. Without hesitating, Julia asked her about it. Her mother laughed and said that she had a rich husband and that she had come with him because he had some business here and that she was doing well. But she was very sorry that she had done that to her child. Then she burst into tears and began to apologize. The women got to talking, and her mother explained to Julia why she hadn't been around all these years. It turned out that she had called her father, but he had threatened her not to even see Julia. The woman was afraid of his rage, and Julia understood her very well, because her father was really scary when he was angry. In an instant, all Julia's childish resentments dissipated. When she came here, she wanted to ask her mother how she could abandon her child. And now she embraced this repentant woman, no longer seeming like a stranger. The women sat for a long time, telling each other their stories. Mom's eyes shone with the kind of love her daughter had never seen in her father's. Then the waiter brought the bill. Julia paid and took her mother back to the hotel. The woman didn't even go into the lobby, despite the cold outside, but stood in the parking lot and waved after the car that was taking her daughter away. Julia met her mother several more times at different restaurants. She did not say anything to her father because her mother asked her to. However, he soon found out from somewhere. He called his daughter into his office and started yelling at her that her mother had not come back for her daughter, but for money, that her rich lover had left her long ago and she did not have a penny. Then the father asked if Julia had given her money. The girl replied that her mother had not asked, but that she had paid for her at restaurants. Father remarked in fury that even this was enough to draw the right conclusions. That evening, Julia had a big fight with her father. She reproached her father that he measured everything in life by dollars, and that's no way to do it. She was already at the door when her father promised her that she would see for herself. A few days later, the father told Julia that he had brought a movie and handed her the CD. The girl asked if the movie was funny, and the father said that for everyone is different. He laughed a long time and his daughter might cry. What Julia saw really brought tears to her eyes. She felt like that little girl who was left alone at home again. But then Julia believed that one day her mother would surely come back. And now she knew for sure that she had lost her mother forever. Julia watched video evidence from her father's office. Here he sits at the desk. Then her mother enters. After a brief exchange of greetings, her father puts a thick envelope on the table and says he wants to make a deal. He pays a sum on which mother can live comfortably for several years, and she promises not to go near his daughter. The mother hesitated briefly, then grabbed the envelope and disappeared from the office. Julia watched the tape several times. She believed her mother because she really wanted her to love her and hoped that they would never part again. But it turned out that her mother wasn't looking for her daughter at all. She was looking for money. Did her mother realize that she would be lonely and unwanted in her old age? Probably not. But this woman lost her only child and just sold her for a bundle of dollars. Dear friends, what do you think about this story? Write your opinion in the comments. Take care and appreciate the people who gave you life and helped you get on your feet. Have a great day and see you again.